إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله، خير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. أما بعد، يقول الله عز وجل: هل أتى على الإنسان حين من الدهر لم يكن شيئا مذكورا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran that there was a time for humankind, they're not something important to be recognized, to be discussed about. And as well, we know that there will come another time after we become non-existent, will not be something important to talk about. What simply tells me, there is a time span, I have some relevance to the world. Before and after, I have no relevance to it. So therefore, everything in this life is about time. And today's discussion in this khutbah, inshallah, is about time and efficient utilization of the time, inshallah. Everything in life we experience, the human experience, is confined within the framework of time. Meaning, when I enjoy something, this is time. When I feel sad about something, it is also about time. When I pray, it is about time. When I fast, it is associated with time. So everything revolves in our life around the time. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes an oath about time. يقول الله عز وجل والعصر. Allah said by the time. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes an oath by any element, it must have some value to it. Whether in a religious context or utilizing common sense, we know that time is of utmost importance in everybody's life. If you logically think that everything we have, more or less, that if we lose them, we can regain them. For example, you are sick, some medication, inshallah, you come back to your original health. If you fail in a class, most likely you can take the course again and hopefully you pass it. You lost your car, you got lost and found, somewhere you end up finding it. So we see that you lost some money, somebody can give as a gift or donation. So whatever we see that we can get, if you end up losing it. But one thing about time, nobody can get it back. Irrespective of the piety of the person, whether the person is pious or not, no cases the time could be regained. It is for a messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or otherwise. So I can see that the time is of utmost importance, that nobody, regardless of their rank, their knowledge, their money, their power, their wealth, or their piety, they cannot get time back. So how in the world any sensible person doesn't take the time and take a look at it? They say that what I have, what I can make out of it. How can a sensible person do not look at their time of this life and maximize the benefit out of it? A benefit which is permanent, not temporary. Here is the point. A benefit which is permanent is not temporary. But guess what? Anything associated with this life is temp. We know that. So therefore, I'm not talking about this life. It is obvious. I'm talking about something else which is permanent. يقول الله عز وجل والآخرة خير وأبقى. Akhirah is better than dunya and longer in duration. So why in the world I will work for something which is limited in time and the quality is so poor, and something is everlasting of better quality. And this quality is defined by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rabbul Alameen. He said that is of better quality. So today's discussion is in context of time. How can I achieve or after, inshallah? So let's defining the importance of time with further more details. And in Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this came in Sahih Muslim, Hadith al-Qudsi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لا تسبوا الدهر إن الله هو الدهر. كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, do not blame the time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the time. But guess what? Al-Dahr is not the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what that's supposed to mean? Imam al-Nawi discussed this in Sharh al-Muslim rahimahullah. He said, Arabs in those days is to blame the time. Any problem? Blame the time. My camel lost, I broke my leg, curse the time. Blame the time. Allah said, do not blame the time. This is the metaphor. Do not blame the time because Allah is the creator of the time. Time is a creation. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala controls the event within the time. And therefore, do not blame the time. If you do so, in essence, you're blaming Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, لا تسبوا الدهر إن الله هو الدهر. So, Allah is the time. And therefore, we never blame the time. The time is not against me. Time is with me. I have a limited allocation of that. So, my job would be taking every second of it and optimizing and efficiently use it for my benefit and my benefit only, inshallah. So objective of this time, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave this time, He has a purpose for the time. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى الذي خلق الموت والحياة ليبلوكم أيكم أحسن عملا. Objective, the time, life and death, between that we call our time. Before my birth, I don't know what time is because I am not connected to it. After my death, I'm not connected to time, so it doesn't matter to me. What it matters, from the life till the death. And Allah gave this little time, أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. To find who is good in conduct, who do more good deed. So here, it is about action associated with time. So Allah gave time, so some action could be produced within that time. A good action. أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. To good deed. That is the objective. So again, I'm here, and you are here, for one common objective, which is to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through a lot of good deeds. Period. Anything else must support that cause. They in itself are not the objective. Again, they are in itself not cause. Objective is please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala good deeds, and anything else should be supporting that cause. An example, like we don't like to go to bathroom. Nobody said my objective of life to go to the restroom all the time. It's never an objective, but it's part of the process. You end up going in, and everybody does, and the Prophet himself sallallahu alaihi wasallam went. So therefore, this is part of the process of life. Even though we do not love to do it, but we end up doing it. But our objective is not go to restroom, but everybody does go to restroom. Likewise, we go to work, we go to school, we eat food, we sleep, we have family. They're not the objective in itself. They're the cause leading to the success of the objective, which is ibadah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Mu'adh radiallahu ta'ala anhu says in a hadith, which came in Bukhari and Muslim both, rahimahullah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he says, I'm paraphrasing the hadith, that when I'm up and when I'm sleeping, both cases I expect equal reward. How so? He says, understanding is that when I sleep, I'm not doing anything, I'm inactive. When I'm up, I'm doing things. For example, I'm visiting a person in the hospital. I'm buying some food for a poor person. I bought a jacket for somebody in need in cold weather. So I'm doing good deeds. I'm praying, I'm fasting, giving charity when I'm up. So I get a lot of hasanat, inshallah, good deeds. But when I sleep, how so? But if a Muslim, when the Muslim sleeps, upon the method of the sunnah of sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and with certain dua, and gets up in the morning with certain dua, and wash up, make wudu, and run to the masjid for salah, when the person slept at night, objective was, I need to rejuvenate me. I need to get my energy back. In the morning, I'm going to make salah, worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then, I'm going to go to work with some halal job, earn some halal money. With that, I maintain my expenses in a halal manner. So everything, halal in there, the key word, that makes this action of the daytime an act of ibadah. The night time, your body prepare for that very action, and the night also becomes act of worship. Subhanallah, Allah made the deen so easy. Right? So the point is, a Muslim's 24/7 is active worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It depends how you line it up. If I line it up for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, including sleep and family, yes, all of them inshallah becomes an act of worship. And therefore, my 24/7 is focused with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, fulfilling the requirement of being worshipping Allah 24/7. As Allah said in Surah Zariyat, Surah number 56, verse number 51, verse number 56, Allah said, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسِ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. I created the jinn and insan for no objective except one. It is so explicit, nothing gets better than that. It is explicit. He said, no reason but except one. If I said Allah created for worship, then I can say worship and something else associated with that. Could be. But he said, no cause but except one cause. That negates everything else in my mind except establishing one thing, that I must worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 24/7. Right? But how long should I continue doing that? How long? For 20 years? 80 years? 7 years? La. Allah says Surah Al-Hijr, Surah number 15, verse, the last verse, 99. Allah said, Wa'bud Rabbaka hatta yatika al-yaqin. Worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala until you die. So this concept of obedience to Allah from day zero or day one until the last day of our life. No exemption from it. So whether I'm a student or a professional, or man or woman, married or unmarried, regardless whatever category we fall under, 24/7 must be dedicated to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I need to work it out. How can I line my education, my job, my sleeping, my family? How can I align all of them for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so they become act of worship? This hadith came in Hakim Sahih al-Albani rahimahullah. Just for the record, any hadith I quote, they're at least at the level of Hassan, لغيره. So at least they're above the lowest level above the lowest level of acceptable hadith by at least one of the hadith scholars, rahimahullah jamia. So inshallah, they're authentic. This hadith came in al-Hakim, Ali Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, اغتنم خمسا قبل خمسة. Take advantage of five things before the five. شبابك قبل حرمك. Take advantage of your youth before you lose the youth. What do I mean? Like if you see a young person, 15, 20, 25, you see the speed in life, the momentum, the way the person move, the person talk, the gesture, right? If somebody 95 rarely moves. Really move, somebody have to push him, right? When they make salah in the chair, it's difficult for them. But somebody young running around, right? So Allah gave you this strength and energy, the momentum. Let us utilize for the pleasure of Allah before the time comes when you can't even move. So the moment you have, now young men and women, come to the masjid for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The moment you get sick or old, you cannot come, it is in the book of the records. It says the person used to come when the person was able to come. The person cannot come because he's not able to come, and therefore the person is considered among those who are coming while they're not coming. Because when the person had the time, they did it. When they don't have the time, they're not responsible for it. Allah doesn't burden the soul with something the person can't bear. So therefore I can what? I can be responsible for coming to the masjid. But while I could what? I'm young and healthy. I was playing around in the street. I didn't come to the house of Allah. So I'll be negligent. So I should try my best to come to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more frequently. The next part of the hadith said, وَصَحَّتِكَ قَبْلَ صَحَّتِكَ قَبْلَ سَقَّمِكَ. Take advantage of your health before the weakness takes over, sickness take over. So this falls on the same category. Whether you're healthy and you can move around, come do good deed for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those who don't have a stomach ulcer, you're healthy. Now Mondays and Thursdays, you should be fasting. You have the physical ability to do so, but when you're 95, you into 10 different pills, you can't do so, and that time you're exempt from doing that. So while I had it, Allah, I did it. Now I can't, and you can see my condition. So we should try to benefit. Each of them can extra time. Now I talked about youth, I talked about health. Healthy is a matter of time. I was healthy 5 years, 2 years I'm sick, matter of time. Youth. This is time, and old age is also time. All are connected to time if you can observe it. The next is, وَبِنَاكَ قَبْلَ فَقَرِكَ. When you have the wealth, maximize the benefit by spending for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But when you become poor, say, Allah, I barely can, bring my food on the table. At this point, I can't do any charity. But last year, you had $100,000 in your account. What do you do with that? I was holding for a better future. Really, the problem is the definition in future. There's a whole different khutbah before that, inshallah. What is future supposed to mean to people? What is future? And what is time now? This perception of people, now and future, we got a little mixed up. We need some clarification on that. But anyhow, so the next point is, faragha, Farag Rakha, that means your free time before you get overwhelmed with activities. So I tell the students, summertime you're free, right? You're not taking any classes. You have 2 months free time, 3 months off. You need to maximize this benefit. You're not working. You go to high school or college, most of the time you're not working. Your parents support you. Now that 2 months and 3 months, I'm going to maximize my benefit. I'm going to get up Qiyamullah every night. Fast every other day if possible, or at least Mondays and Thursdays. I'm going to go to some program studying the deen. Either Arabic language, or the aqidah, or usul, or fiqh, or tafsir, or hadith. Something I'm going to admit myself into so I can learn these 3 months. So if you go to college for 4 years or 5 years, you got 4 or 5 summers. That's about 15 months. SubhanAllah, 15 months, what can you not do and you're not working? That 15 months, somebody doesn't work, is equals to maybe more than 30 months. The 30 months of free time, what have you done with that for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? This is time, being accountable for it. So every one of us need to utilize the time in a more efficient manner. Now, if I change the direction, that we are accountable with time and what we are going to do in this life, the moment of exit and day of judgment, if I do not use the time properly. That is the discussion. Next. أقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, this hadith came in Tirmidhi, لا تزول قدم عبد يوم القيامة حتى يسأل عن عمره فيما أفناه كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. Day of judgment, a person can move their legs, the foot, can move it, until and unless Allah takes account, how did he use the time? SubhanAllah. That's a disaster. That's a calamity awaiting for us. It is time just about to come for us. Allah will ask about every single day, what have you done? 2016, December 5th, 2 p.m., what did you do? December 29th, 2013, at 3 p.m., what did you do? The detailness of this accountability is his skill. So Allah will ask about every fine details and we have to answer to it. If I don't answer, I can move. People may ask, shall I be tied to the ground? Answer is no. Shall I be tied to a wheelchair? Answer is no. So why don't you move? Because people are in terrified observation of the day of judgment. The terror and horror of day of judgment, people will be terrified. Except those who did good deeds, they have peace and security from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what means good deed and how much to be done? This is subjective, again, but it requires a different discussion. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks about time. So each of us need to look at our life before Allah takes an account. I need to take my account and ask myself, what can I do about it? If you look at, in a general sense, each day you have about 86,400 seconds. Each day we have 86,400 seconds. Either you use each of them or lose it. Either you use each of them or you lose it. Now I am saying in seconds, as a unit of time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may choose to go in nanosecond, picosecond. I just don't know. But I'm saying seconds. So over 86,000 seconds per day, each of the second, what have I done? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may choose to ask about it. And what is my answer to him? Is it not smart that I look at myself, self-analyze it, do ihtisab, see how much I use my time and what affairs, so I can find out where do I belong. My people, before they file the tax, they collect all the documents, see all of them lined up properly or not. If you get audited, you have 3 years chance they can audit you anytime for 3 years. So you need to get your document lined up, put in a folder. What if the auditor asks you, show me this document. This tax exemption you wanted, show me the documents for that. You deducted $20,000 for this, show me the deduction document. Oh, I had it, I don't have it. That's not going to work. That's not going to work. The day of judgment, Allah can ask you, why did you do this? Didn't you know about it? Yes, I know. So why do you do it? Did you think Allah doesn't know about it? Or you thought Allah doesn't account for it? Or you thought day of judgment won't come any day? What is the problem? We need to ask ourselves, how do you utilize our time, inshallah? To conclude this part of the discussion, yesterday is gone. Tomorrow is not guaranteed. It's a mystery. What I have is today. And today the whole day is not guaranteed either. At this very moment is guaranteed. So what I'm going to do from this moment, I'm going to look at this as an opportunity to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And every moment, 2 p.m., I'm going to try to do something. 3 p.m., I'm going to do something. If I can do it in between, I'll try to do good deeds. Between my work, subhanAllah, alhamdulillah, smile at the face of a person, give somebody a right, do some good deed for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every day and every moment of it, if I try my best. Because if I don't use the time will pass. The sin remains in the book, by the way. The fun part is over. But the documentation in relation to the sin, which was associated with that fund, remains in the book. And Allah is going to ask about it. وقولي هذا استغفر الله ولي ولكم الله اكبر الله اكبر الله اكبر ان الحمد لله والصلاه والسلام على رسول الله وعلى اله واصحابه ومن والاه. Now the time is so important, as I started with, Allah Azza wa Jalla said, wal asr, woe by a time, Allah swore by a time, innal insana lafi khusr. And it's written on that board as well, mashallah, this is a good thing. It said, wal asr innal insana lafi khusr. Verily, Allah take a word by time and say, everybody's a loser. Everybody's a loser. Imagine the blank statement, like saying that everybody's a loser, that brings a shock and awe in people's mind. You can see in a classroom, and a student, he said, everybody failed the midterm exam. You see the face turn pale, each of them. Even the best students say, everybody fail? If the best student expected to get 100, you look at the student, everybody failed midterm, it's so sad. See, everybody's face turned blue. See the shock, right? And Allah said, innal insana lafi khusr. Everybody's a loser. And he says, so? We don't even pay attention to it. It doesn't matter to us. Because Allah said, وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ. We don't give Allah's due honor and right. We don't respect Him as He deserves to be respected. His word doesn't mean much to us. It's a problem. It's a fundamental problem for the Muslim. They don't care. It's like another story in a newspaper. This is the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah said, وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ مِنَ اللَّهِ قِيلًا. Who speaks better than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Who speaks? None. No one. So therefore Allah's word means something. And we need to recognize that. We need to react this way. Allah said, إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ. Everybody's a loser. So we are sad. We are devastated by it. Then Allah said, إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. Then the hope comes. Then I see light end of the tunnel. Allah said, except those who believe and do good deed. Do good deed, ahsanu amala. Good deed in this given time. So this time called life need to be filled with a lot of good deeds. And that will bring success. And otherwise, Allah said, you'll be among the losers. So we ask Allah's protection from it. And if you talk to the young men and women, one of the key elements they say, Allah says, what are you doing? I'm killing time. I'm chilling, I'm killing time. They're having fun. Say killing time. You don't kill time. Time is not an enemy. Time is a friend. Time is an investment. And if you utilize, get benefit out of it. The time is not something you kill, you chill. Time you utilize and maximize the benefit so I can enjoy day of judgment. Chilling is day of judgment. Now is work time. Weekdays you work, weekend you relax. This is our weekdays. The entire life is weekdays. And weekend is day of judgment. Weekend is day of judgment when we go to the paradise. The angel at the door of the paradise says, Salamun alaykum tibtum fatkulu wa khalidin. Angel say, Assalamu alaikum, job well done, come into the paradise. Our weekend starts and never ends. Our weekend starts and never ends. But guess what? We have to work in weekdays here. And we took this life as weekend. Just a mistake and a fundamental one. Unless you fix it, we'll be in disaster. Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم, this hadith came in Bukhari. لَنِعْمَتَانِ مَغْبُونٌ فِيهِمَ كَثِيرًا مِّنَ النَّاسِ كَثِيرٌ مِّنَ النَّاسِ السِّحَّ وَالْفَرَقِ أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. The two of the elements Allah blessed people with, they abuse them, misuse them, and waste them, which is free time and good health. السِّحَّ وَالْفَرَقِ. Good time, you enjoy the life. When you're sick, in a hospital bed, Allah help me, if you do that, I'll come to the masjid. Why now? What happened in the past? What happened in the past? And the free time, Allah, if I had some free time, I would do worship. I would learn the deen, I would study the deen so much that I would become Imam An-Nawawi, rahimahullah. But what do you do when you have free time playing around? But this kind of excuse is not going to work. So we need to use our time more efficient manner. What happened in the past, we can't change it. We ask Allah's forgiveness. But when I have time now, I need to maximize my benefit, inshallah. The Qul Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِذَا جَاءَ أَحَدُهُمُ الْمَوْتِ. When the death of some person comes in, very close to the death, the person says, رَبِّ ارْجِعُونِي لَعَلِّي عَمَلَ صَالِحًا فِي مَا تَرَكْتُ. So Allah, can you send me back? I'm about to die. So can you send me back from this path? So why do you want to go back? More fun, more weekends? No. I want to do some good deeds. What kind of good deeds do you want to do? فِي مَا تَرَكْتُ, the good deeds I should have done, I didn't do them. I need to make it up for it. But it's too late. Time is up. So while I have the time,
I better utilize it so I do not have to regret that day. Another regret in day of judgment. This is at the moment of death. That is day of judgment. يَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِي قَدَّمْتُ لِحَيَاتِ. Woe to myself, I wish I have done some good for this life. Wishing, everybody will do wishing day of judgment. But no fruit, no result. So while I can do some good deed now, stop wishing for it. Let us do it. And utilize and maximize my benefit for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. People spend so much time working and collecting money, and they get old and sick, use the money to fix themselves. So it really doesn't benefit much. Spend so much time for money. لَمْ يَلْبَسُوا إِلَّا عَشِيَةً أَوْ ضُحَاهَا. This life, compared to Akhirah, is a morning or afternoon. For that, so much preparation. For that, so much sweating to get some cash. I'm not against it, but we're doing too much of it. Here's the point. Need some optimization, need some balance. I'm not against running money, because you have to pay the bills. But we're getting obsessed with money, that's the problem right there. Obsession with it is a problem. Living in the world, having your share of the world, nothing wrong with that. Allah said, لَا تَنْسَ نَسِبَكَ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا. Do not forget your share of this life. Nothing wrong with that. But the ayah start with, وَفْتَدِي فِي مَا آتَكَ اللَّهُ دَارَ الْآخِرَةِ. Gather all your resources, work towards Akhirah. Once you have done so, enjoy the dunya as well. Don't forget about it totally. Don't be a monk on the top of the mountain. But this verse doesn't apply to us. We are too much into the dunya, it doesn't apply to us. We are overwhelmed by the dunya and forget the Akhirah. So therefore, we need to work hard for this Akhirah, inshallah. To conclude the matter, some of the key elements, what should we do, what should we not do? So this is the time, how do I use it? I give some examples for it. But before that, if you remember, Imam An-Nawi rahimahullah died in early 40s. Imam An-Nawi, who did the Sharh al-Muslim. He was a giant scholar of his time, a giant. In early 40s, many of us, including myself, crossed that. Inna lillahi, look at myself, I say inna lillahi. I said, what a loss of my life. I'm not making it up, I'm not giving you stories. This is up front, that's what I said to myself. I said, I crossed 40 and what did he do his 40 years? What did I do with my 40 years? What a loss. What a regret in my life. What a useless waste of time for myself. What did I do for the pleasure of Allah? How can he do that day? I couldn't do it. But guess what? Look at their life and the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. If they need water, they have to go in a well. Like walk 10 blocks, for example, get some water. You need water, you turn the faucet on. Not only cold, hot water as well. Wow. You get all ready. Coffee and donuts right there. And to make a donut, they take 2 hours to make it. And doesn't taste that good. Their life requires so much labor and have to invest so much time for little thing to be done. But they did more ibadah than us. And we have so many facilities, a life full of ease and automation. But still we are behind in ibadah. How so? Doesn't it require some thinking? I think any intelligent mind should sit down and think that how come we have more time, everything advanced, fast, automated, unlike their lifestyle. Your dark, flick the light switch on, is on. Hot, turn the AC on. Cold, turn the heater on. But they have none of that, Bob. But they did more worship than me. How so? So what I'm doing with my life? Is it a waste? We need to think. This is about food for thought and reflecting on the mind. And have I used my time in an appropriate manner? Or I'm running like, you know, a headless chicken for something that we're never going to retain in our life. We go empty-handed in the grave. If you didn't know, you see some of the janazas. Go to the graveyard, see the person go empty-handed. You can look in the coffin, he said, let me see the hand, do you have something in your pocket? Nothing. And live for somebody else. What a waste of life. Smart people take things for themselves, don't live for others. We've got to be smart in our thinking, inshallah. Now, Mu'adh ibn Jabal, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who is the imam of the scholars, died in early 30s. Anybody cross 30 plus? We need to ask ourselves, including me, that what have I done? When I pass 30 and this person passed 32, how can he become that and I become nothing? Where is the mistake? What did I got things wrong and how did I got things right? We need to analyze them, right? Many people read in the train, sometimes I see, how to be a billionaire, right? Somebody writes a book, how you got your first billion. They want to see the lifestyle, somebody has money. To them, somebody becomes successful, they want to see their lifestyle. They are the people who are successful. Allah said, radiallahu ta'ala anhum radwan. They're successful. So I need to read their lifestyle and bio. What did they do? I'm trying to align my life with that. That should be the goal for every Muslim. It is just not a talk. This is a way of life. Talk should spark the thought process, but must maintain and continue till we die. Inshallah. Now, first and foremost thing, we should utilize the time by earning the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Earning the knowledge about Allah azza wa jal. Get to know your Lord, whom you worship every day. Get to know Allah ilaha illallah. Then get to know Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What do I mean? Get to know what Tawheed of La ilaha illallah is supposed to mean. What this really means, these few words, what that's supposed to mean. What's so big about it? That simply means in one line that my 24/7 goes according to the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That La ilaha illallah means in general sense. And Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam means in a general sense, my 24/7 of obedience to Allah must be in the method prescribed by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Khalas. La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, done. The religion is complete. But to do this, it is a lifetime effort. It's a lifetime effort. We should try to do our best. And we need to do good deeds. Race for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَسَابِكُونَ الْأَوَّلُونَ. We need to race, become the first and the foremost in terms of doing good deeds. I shouldn't wait till tomorrow. I want to do it today. Other affairs I do tomorrow if I live. Good deeds I need to do today and tonight, not tomorrow morning. That's how the life is. I need to optimize and benefit from every moment of our life, inshallah. Now, young men and women, another thing, that one of the epidemic of this age and time is the cell phone, i.e. the internet, through the cell phone, which is Facebook, Twitter, what have you, all this, people are wasting their time. Facebook, yes, some of the ulama use them, there's benefit to it, yes. It is like a knife. You could be a surgeon doing surgery, or you could be somebody, you know, stabbing somebody in the street. It depends how you utilize it, the phone. I utilize my phone 24/7. All my studies, Islamic studies, the phone with me is here. My notes, study of fiqh and usul, everything. I note it, then I take my home and put it in my computer. Right? So use all the time. The Quran and hadith, everything in the phone. So really, I want to be using all the time. But if you use that purpose, it's good. But you hold it, uploading pictures, taking your own pictures, uploading in the system. SubhanAllah, one of the funniest things I see, the Muslims, like otherwise, other people, take their own picture. If I ask myself, how many times you need to see yourself? Have you not seen yourself enough? You didn't change from yesterday much, right? You look the way you looked yesterday, this week you won't be a different person. So why are you taking a picture all the time? And some sisters are obsessed with that. That shows the heart is connected to the dunya regardless of how many umrah you made. I'm being upfront, blunt. Because we are in intensive care, it requires intensive discussion. I think the heart is connected to the dunya regardless how many times you made umrah and hajj. That's beside the point. Your heart is somewhere else, even though you're doing religious action. I need to bring the heart in alignment with Allah, then do action on the top of that. Because mind is connected to dunya. Dunya, dunya, dunya. You need to stop that, step back. Say, akhira, akhira, now start doing it. So the dunya is the key element in everybody's mind. I am to be the president. I am to be a senator. I am to be a mayor. I need a degree to show off. I need a degree to show off. People call me this and that. Say again, dunya. Having the degree is not a problem. The intention behind is the problem. So I'm saying this, young men and women, rather than wasting time in the Facebook, Twitter, and surfing the net, if you're not a journalist, then please don't spend 2 hours in reading the news, if you're not a journalist. So I check the news, I check it too, I'm not blind about the word. We can have a discussion, I'm not. I'm aware of that. You can ask me what is an impeachment, I can tell you. But it takes only 5 minutes to go through it. Done. But people spend 2-3 hours reading newspapers and online. You're wasting your time, you're not a journalist. Why are you looking so much into it? What is the problem? You do the time in an efficient manner. And if you have nothing better to do, some young men and women, nothing better to do, go to the gym and exercise, it's fine. Because I want a good health so I can stay up night, pray two hours of camel like I want to do because I'm a healthy person. Or I'm going to help somebody doing free construction work in the masjid. I'm a healthy person. Or I'll do security for the masjid. I'm a healthy person. Or do martial art. Get 9-degree black belt. And do be good and protect the community, yes. But whatever you do must be connected to a good objective. Or do a degree, finish one degree, to bachelor to master, finish bachelor to PhD, PhD finish to postdoc. Go ahead, continue. Get a certification, get a license, whatever, something productive. And Facebook uploading, just pictures and sisters cooking their food, uploading in the Facebook, is not productive. It is non-productive, waste of time. Allah gave the time for a much better objective. And you need to gain the objective of the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So whatever you understand is good. Community service. The last thing in the masjid, any masjid around here, you can have a soup kitchen, Sundays. Go to homeless people, give them blankets. Do something productive for the pleasure of Allah and a community service. And people see Islam, Muslims are good people. We are, by the way, but we don't demonstrate that. So whatever the case is, let us utilize the time for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, efficient manner, starting with learning the deen of Allah azza wa jalla, because absence of knowledge is a key element of destruction of the people today and in the past. وقولي هذا استغفر الله ولي ولكم اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا اسرافنا في امرنا وثبت اقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين اللهم اصلح عقدتنا في الامور كلها واجرنا من خزي الدنيا وعذاب الاخره اللهم رب ارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا ربنا هب لنا من ازواجنا وذريتنا قرة اعين واجعلنا للمتقين اماما اقيم الصلاه ورحمه